Pulling an aircraft with a tow bar can be a real pain. Maybe you have uneven or soft ground. Maybe you have slippery ground with limited traction for your shoes. Maybe you have to pull a plane a long distance to get to a nice paved area to start your engine. Maybe you just want something easier. Now there is a huge market for aircraft tugs, with some of the dedicated aircraft tugs being sold for thousands of dollars each. Now that's not what this video is about. This video is about how to build a solid tow setup for a fraction of what these dedicated aircraft tugs will cost, so that you can free up money to spend on other things in life. So stick around and watch this video. There's lots of cool ideas on how to build your own aircraft tug, as well as how to build your own cool tow bar setup. Now let's get started. Here's my setup. I bought a riding lawnmower off of Facebook Marketplace. I saw that this particular one was a higher horsepower model. It's got a 22 horsepower Briggs & Stratton engine. I bought a new battery and I also changed the fuel filter. I did an oil change, had to fix a small fuel leak. I ended up removing the mower deck, which I might sell later to get some of my money back. I also found the ignition switch was bad, so I bought a new one off of Amazon. After that, this mower fired right up. To prep the mower for towing, I built a bracket on the front using some steel plate as well as some square tubing. I installed it using longer bolts in the existing holes of where a skid plate used to be on the mower. I installed an ATV hitch ball on the front as well as on the back. For extra traction on the snow and ice, I installed a set of tire chains on the drive tires. For the tow bar, I bought 1-inch thin-walled steel square tubing as well as some 1/16 inch steel plate. I measured the hole spacing on the nose fork of my aircraft and built a tow bar that would engage into these holes with safety pins to keep the bar on the aircraft. All the pieces were cut using a metal chop saw and they were welded together using a MIG welder. My 5-year-old daughter helped me and this project ended up being a really cool father-daughter project. Now, whenever she sees that tow bar, she knows that she helped Dad build it. As a bonus, my aircraft also came with this nasty tow bar. It was so long that it actually sat beside my arm on the trip home. I cut out the damaged pieces and made it into a travel tow bar that can be collapsed to a smaller size, and it's made so that it straps into my cargo area for those cross-country trips. Now I know what some of you are going to say. I posted this setup on a chat group before and had people quickly tell me that I'm going to oversteer the aircraft and damage the steering stops. I suppose that could happen if I actually oversteered the aircraft. The truth is that in my younger years, I was a ground handler at the Calgary International Airport and was used to towing around much larger aircraft than this Piper Tomahawk. I was often towed around 737s, 757s, 767s, even Airbus A310s, I think even an A340 at one point. So it's not something new to me. And if you're really concerned about oversteering, what you could do is figure out where your steering stop is, and you could mark a line on one point of the fuselage and not turn the tow bar past that line. That could give you a safety margin. And again, if you're uncomfortable with your driving, maybe a setup like this isn't so good for that reason of oversteering the aircraft. For me, I'm comfortable with it and it works great. Hopefully this gives you a good idea on what will work for your aircraft. Click up here to subscribe to this channel. You'll be notified on when the next videos come out. Thanks for watching. See you on the next one.